all good pilgrimage site.
Okay, so we ripped off the Where in the World is Carmen Sandiego theme song. But hey, we tried. Random Catholic thoughts, list videos, and more for Bored Laity. The practice of making a pilgrimage is ancient and holy, and not limited to Christianity. It is a practice that is designed to draw you deeper into your faith. But where to go? Obviously, it should be somewhere that has meaning for you, perhaps even one of the following. So here are 8 amazing pilgrimages. Before going any further, here's the obligatory request to subscribe and click the bell icon. The Holy Land, Jerusalem and Bethlehem. Ah, the Holy Land, where Christ walked upon the earth. Every Christian should visit the Holy Land in their lifetime. The two essential sites are, of course, the Church of the Holy Sepulchre in Jerusalem and the Church of the Nativity in Bethlehem. We here at RCUT have been to these locations and can tell you from experience to expect large crowds. Also, due to the complicated political situation in the region, best to go with a designated tour group, and it's very important to keep any documentation and identification, like your passport, secure and up to date at all times. The Holy Sepulchre is where Christ died and was laid in the tomb. It contains several stations of the cross. While at the Church of the Nativity in Bethlehem, you can see what is believed to be the exact spots where Christ was born and where he lay in the manger. If you take a brief walk down the road from the church, you can pray at the Milk Grotto, where Mary nursed Jesus. Tradition says that the Holy Family briefly took refuge here during the slaughter of the innocents prior to leaving for Egypt. Lough Derg, Ireland. According to legend, Christ once showed a cave to St. Patrick that was on this island that is supposedly an entrance to purgatory. According to historical fact, documents have noted this as a holy site since the 1100s. The famous 3-day pilgrimage requires you must be at least 15 years old and in good enough physical condition to withstand the barefoot walking and the long hours of kneeling and prayer. Not to mention the fasting. Pilgrims eat only one simple meal each day. Right off the bat, on day one is a 24-hour vigil, no sleeping. This is a pilgrimage that is truly designed to rip you away from the modern world and to bring you into a deeper connection to the spiritual world. Never mind elbowing through flocks of tourists wielding selfie sticks in grand basilicas. Smaller groups of pilgrims gather in the summer months to slow down, contemplate, and pray. Admission is 75 euros or about 85 US dollars. So this video is part 1 of 6. For the next entry, you will need to make a pilgrimage of your own. Head on over to the channel Kid Catholic.
Hello everyone, I hope you enjoyed stop 1 of the pilgrimage with Random Catholic Thoughts. I am stop 2, I am Kid Catholic, and I am going to talk about St. Croce in Jerusalem. So I was lucky enough to go to Rome, and there is a church called St. Croce in Jerusalem that is in Rome. And in the church, there is a little side chapel, and in the side chapel, there's a glass case that has some incredible things in it. It has thorns from the crown of thorns. It has a nail that nailed Jesus to the cross. It has a finger of St. Thomas the Doubter, the finger that touched the side of Christ. It also has a large beam of the cross from one of the thieves who was next to Jesus when Jesus was crucified, as well as a piece of the cross from Jesus's cross, the cross that he was crucified on. And the room next to that, there is an exact copy of the shroud. So you get to see the face print of Jesus Christ. It is absolutely incredible, and it's by far my favorite church in all of Rome. Now head on over to stop 3 of your pilgrimage with Emma Lou Nicole.
Hey cats, the licks, I'm Emma Lou Nicole, and this is your third stop on the pilgrimage. You previously saw Kid Catholic. Isn't he amazing? He's totally amazing. For right now, we're gonna be talking about the Shrine of Our Lady of Lourdes. Take a look at this map of France. Here's Paris, the capital. Right here is Lourdes, and we all know what's there. And right here is Arsinoe, where there is a 24-hour oyster vending machine. But that's not important right now. Finally, right here is Lourdes, the location of a rather obscure Vatican-approved Marian apparition. The Virgin Mary was given the title Our Lady of Lourdes because of her appearances to a young shepherd in 1664. The shrine has since been a place of pilgrimage since the 1700s. But interestingly enough, apparitions didn't get the Vatican stamp of approval until 2008. Now it's true that this shrine is not as popular as compared to, say, Lourdes, and that the town of Lourdes is tucked away in the Alps, so getting there will take some planning. But it's exactly that sort of peaceful seclusion that makes it a good pilgrimage site. The message of Our Lady of Lourdes is reconciliation, penance, and the call to holiness. At the shrine, confession and adoration are available every day. The sacred oil from the basilica was promised by Our Lady to give spiritual and physical healing. Spiritual activities and retreats are led by lay people and the local Benedictine sisters. You can find designated pilgrimage groups, or you can travel independently. You'll find a link to the Shrine's website in the description box below. Thank you guys so much for watching. This has been the third stop of your pilgrimage. Now buckle up and get ready for stop number 4, which will be done by the Popish Plot. And remember, to always stay holy and stay cool, cats. So licks.
Welcome to the Popish Plot. I'm Nate.
I'm Jessica.
And I'm Mike. Thank you for joining us on this, the fourth stop of our pilgrimage. Thank you very much to Emma Lou Nicole for her wonderful job on the previous step. At this point, we are going to be traveling to the Solanus Casey Center.
In the fall of 2017, I had the exquisite privilege of attending the Beatification Mass for then Venerable Solanus Casey at Detroit's own Ford Field. It was a great privilege to see the home of the Detroit Lions filled to the brim with my fellow Catholics. The Capuchin Friars and the Archdiocese of Detroit did a great job of organizing it. It went very smoothly. It was a brilliant time, and what I remember most fondly, aside from, of course, receiving our Blessed Savior in the Eucharist, was the song that they sang over and over again, that this was a victory for our God. When any one of us becomes the saint, or is recognized as the saint that God created us to be.
That's very cool. It's cool because it's probably the only time they've been singing about victory at the home of the Lions in a long, long time.
Solanus Casey was an American Capuchin known for his incredible hospitality and ability to inspire people to grow in holiness throughout the early part of the 20th century.
Ooh, Capuchins. Those are those cute little monkeys and you can get them to do stuff for you?
Yes, those are called Capuchins, but they're called that because their fur kind of looks like the hood worn by Capuchin monks. They are one of the 75,000 or so different types of Franciscans that exist in the world.
Those are the ones who made coffee.
I believe so.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, the highly caffeinated Franciscans.
Well, that explains why he was so hospitable.
Who brought us the...
Have a cup of coffee.
Who Everyone brought us coffee. The fantastic Capuchin... No.
Mm-hmm. Did they?
I believe they That's actually awesome. Did invent the so. Cappuccino.
That completely makes sense. Anyway, holiness is still something that we should strive for here in the 21st century.
It's why a pilgrimage to the Solanus Casey Center is such a great idea. It was designed to be a sacred space for prayer and spiritual growth. While it is not a shrine, there is a church there and the tomb of Blessed Solanus.
I believe that's where the miracle that resulted in getting beatified happened.
Yes. The center offers mass every day. Confessions are available Monday through Saturday.
Especially given how hard it can be to get to confession in your local parish, you know, the 15 minutes a week that it's offered.
Yeah.
That's pretty nice.
That's pretty fantastic. Yeah. The center also offers the ancient practice of the blessing of the sick, which Blessed Solanus did very often, which is how the miracle tended to occur, is that he was often known for blessing the sick and for, you know...
Yes.
In his life,
the last one was a healing of an incurable thing.
Exactly.
But even in his life, he was known as a miracle man.
Yeah.
Yep.
That God would answer his prayers, especially. Mm-hmm.
Great thing about it is that the blessings are offered multilingually.
Ooh.
You can get them in English, Wednesday through Sunday. They're also available in Spanish and English on the first Sundays of the month.
Muy bien.
And Arabic and English every third Sunday. Because, as some people may be aware of, and some may not, there is actually a very large Arabic community in that area of Michigan, and not all of them are Muslim.
No, there's a huge number of Chaldean Christians and others.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly.
It's actually the largest Arab population outside of the Middle East.
Exactly.
In the Detroit metro area.
Yep.
If you want to lead a group, because, come on, pilgrimage is more fun when you're in a group, and rent out one of the facilities, you can do that too. There'll be links to the center's website in the description box.
So we hope you enjoyed this stop on our pilgrimage of holy sites. We hope that you will stay tuned, go follow through to the next stop, the fifth stop, which is going to be done by Brad Schapizzi. And until next time, remember to live your faith.
Love your faith.
Share that love.
Welcome, I'm Brad Schapizzi, and this is the fifth stop of our YouTube pilgrimage. Be sure to check out the previous stop on the channel The Popish Plot. Shrine of the Most Blessed Sacrament, Alabama, USA. The Shrine of the Most Blessed Sacrament is a very important place for me. For the last 15 years, my family has made a yearly pilgrimage to this spot to thank God for all the blessings that He has given us in the last year. The Shrine of the Most Blessed Sacrament is located in Hanceville, Alabama, less than an hour from Birmingham. It also serves as a cloistered monastery for the Poor Clare Nuns of Perpetual Adoration. The shrine opened in 1999 in honor of Jesus truly present in the Holy Eucharist. It is home to a 7.5-foot tall monstrance. Pilgrims are invited to spend time in adoration of the Blessed Sacrament, attend Mass, confession, and join the sisters in praying the Liturgy of the Hours. A link to the shrine's website is in the description box. San Michele on the Gargano. The spur of the boot that is Italy is home to two Catholic pilgrimage sites. The first one is San Giovanni Rotondo, where you can find the shrine and tomb of Padre Pio. The other is Monte Sant'Angelo, that features the shrine of San Michele Gargano, or St. Michael's Cave. The story goes that in the late 400s, after some apparitions by St. Michael the Archangel, the actions of a doubting bishop, and various other occurrences that reflect the triumph of Christianity over a mysterious pagan cult, this cave became a holy site of prayer. The cave is actually fairly small, with a separate section where confessions can be heard. Another fairly small thing is this famous statue of the Archangel. May 8th is a good day to be here, as that's the day that commemorates the apparitions. But really, any time is a good time to make the pilgrimage, and to ask St. Michael to defend us in battle, and to be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. For the sixth and final stop of this YouTube pilgrimage, head back over to the channel Random Catholic Thoughts. Thank you for watching this video. We will see you in the next one.
The Two Shrines Pilgrimage, Scotland. This is a very new pilgrimage. It was started by the Confraternity of St. Ninian, with the ultimate purpose of reconverting Scotland to the faith. The pilgrimage itself consists of 3 days of walking from the modern shrine of St. Andrew in Edinburgh to the ruins of the ancient shrine in the nearby town of St. Andrews. Along the way, pilgrims will sing hymns, pray the rosary, listen to spiritual talks, and celebrate the traditional Latin Mass, not to mention good old-fashioned fellowship with other pilgrims. For a more in-depth look, check out the video from Sancta Familia Media, link in the description box. If you're interested, the pilgrimage takes place in August, and there is a 1 or 2 day pilgrimage option. The cost is about £90, or about $115 US for the whole thing. You can also donate to sponsor someone else. Again, special thanks to Kid Catholic, Emma Lunicole, The Popish Plot, and Brad Schapizzi for being a part of this epic 5-channel crossover. Go subscribe to them all. Links to the other videos are in the description box.